Hello once again, YouTube, and welcome to another video by me, Robert Lewis, at the Knights of Awesomeness. And today, we're going to be having a look at something that's not related to Doctor Who. What? Something that's not related to Doctor Who? Well, I can't believe this anymore. Yes, no Doctor Who to be found here outside that TARDIS right over there, but that's part of my background, you could say, or just a stylistic choice. Today we will be looking at the Souls Black series Death Trooper. I said that I would be looking at good Star Wars action figures. Indeed, I didn't lie. As they said in the movie. That's what I heard. Yeah, and this is number 25 of the Black Series. And basically, the packaging is the same for all the Black Series outside the drawings they have on it and the bios. So, imagine this here. Just zoom out. Or move it out. Yeah, it's the same. It's all the same outside the Toys R Us exclusive exclusive thingy-majiggy there, sticker, and the drawing, and the First Order Stormtrooper, and the bio and stuff. And there's no number on that because that was an exclusive. I did have the packaging though. Even my mother destroyed it and sent it to the garbage, or the bin, as normal people call it. But we're not normal people, aren't we? So by the way, my thoughts on Rogue One have changed. They have. Now it goes 1, 2... Rogue One, 1, 2, 3, Rogue One, 7, 6, 4, 5. There we go. Yeah, I'm now realizing that characters come before plot, I guess. So, anyway, enough of that. Let's have a look at the detail on this dude. Now, holy Christ, this dude is packed to the brim full of details. It looks exactly like a shrunk down version of the Death Troopers it does. You can see the weird 011 on there. Instead of the normal one, it goes down and the 011 is a little bit smaller. You can see all the equipment that he has to carry all the time. You can see it looks slightly Stormtrooper-ish, but not quite, since he's in black colours. The helmet, though, they could have made the eyes and these two things black, but as you can see, I don't know if it shows up on camera, but they're actually green, just like in the movie, because these guys would be used. Would sneak up on you in the dark, and they could see you in the dark and strike you down before you even knew it. He comes with a blaster rifle that is a new blaster rifle. As you can see, the detail on this is pretty amazing. You know, it looks like a combination of old Clone Wars weapons, such as this. This kind of reminds me of the did. The DC-15A blaster rifle that the clones carried out. And this, I don't know, it kind of looks pretty cool, but his other blaster is definitely not new to the Star Wars universe. It's a SE-17 blaster pistol, and it looks exactly like, which was the standard blaster pistol of all stormtroopers. It was back in the Empire, and it's weirdly in the same texture as this. This isn't the color of these two aren't really accurate, but what can you do? They look lovely, and they look much better than what they would have looked like in the smaller scale of figures. So yeah, for detail on the figure and the guns, it's a pretty good detail. Now on to articulation. His head can do the full 360 degrees no scope. His head can look up and then look right down and look at his junk. His arms can go out all the way because this is flexible plastic. They can swivel all the way round, which is actually pretty good. Hey, that's pretty good. They can go do that, and the hands can do that, and do that, and the legs can swivel, even though it's a little bit hard to do, and they can kick out, and they have that ankle rocker pivot that everybody loves, and they can do the splits, that means. There you go. Oh my lord! Let's see how it can stand. Oh my god! Great Scott! This figure tends to fall down, it does. But there's one thing that kind of redeems it. If you're an avid collector of the Star Wars, the Black Series range of figures, especially after the Force Awakens line was released, you usually know that they don't really hold their guns properly, because they don't, or lightsabers, or whatever projectile weapon. But now, see, you can get him doing this. But with this figure, that was an earlier or older figure, you can't really get him doing this. I can't really get him into that pose. With this, there you go, you can. Which is a good thing. So you can display your figure in a pretty badass pose, I guess. Yeah. Also, this is his trigger hand, where his CE-17 blaster pistol and this gun can fit nice and snug into it. You can't really fit any guns into this one because it's hasn't got the trigger finger. Yeah. These guys in Rogue One were complete badasses. Like, they managed to take down, like, two of the main characters. I think it was Baze Malbus and Chewit Inwe. But also, he's got a sidearm thingamajiggy where he can hold his blaster pistol. Not his blaster rifle. Trust me, I tried. It failed. Yeah, so overall, what do I think of this figure? Well, it's a pretty neat figure, I would say. The details from... The detail makes it look like it came straight out of the actual movie. Yeah. The articulation's superb, more so than this loser right here. The detail on the color. I wish they could paint the guns a little bit differently because they didn't appear like this in the movie. But what can you do? Such is life. You should really get this figure, but be warned, my friend. Getting this figure is really hard because it's an awesome badass death trooper, so it's really hard to get this figure. I think on eBay, I haven't checked or anything, they're probably going up for £50. These guys look badass, and they are appearing in Star Wars Rebels, which gives me even more reason to review this figure. which is amazing. The only thing about these figures, the only thing I really hate about the Death Troopers is that they sound like you can't barely understand what they're saying, can't you? But that's the only thing. Overall, they were badass in the movie. The movie was okay. It's the first okay Star Wars film you eat. Most Star Wars films are terrible, disastrous, terrible, meh, good, great, brilliant, and excellent. But now this is the first okay one. So yeah, that was my review of the Death Trooper, and I'll see you next time when I'm going to be reviewing Attack of the Cybermen. So stay tuned for that. Bye, bitch.